You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where Sethu talks all about a brand new feature in Azure Machine Learning called Managed Endpoints. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're talking all about managed endpoints. I've got a special guest. Sethu, why don't you introduce yourself? Tell us who you are and what you do, my friend.
Hey, Seth. So my name is Sethu Raman. I'm a product manager in Azure ML, focusing primarily in the inference side of things.
Fantastic. So let's start first with, look, software deployments in general are hard. It's got to be even harder with machine learning and with machine learning-based software. What are y'all doing to help?
So we've been hearing from a lot of our customers who have been working with us, and we're releasing this new capability called Managed Online Endpoints as a part of public preview and build, which gives users the ability to bring their model and deploy it across powerful GPU and CPU computes in Azure. Primarily, I want to call out three things, Seth. Okay. First one is the managed infrastructure. So users need not worry about creating a cluster, upgrading it, and so on. So the system takes care of the underlying patching of the software, host upgrading the host images, recovering from failure. All of this is handled for you. The second thing is we spent a lot of time in thinking about the ops support for machine learning. Here, we give users the ability to do safe rollout of their models using a native support for blue-green deployment. We give a built-in support for Azure Monitor integration to give SLA monitoring. And then we also integrate with log analytics and app insights and more. And the third thing is debuggability. And one primary thing I want to call out here is the local endpoint support, where users would be able to deploy and test and debug iteratively their endpoint logic in their local Docker container. And I want to talk about a new concept we are introducing here, which is the endpoint and the deployments. So here, the clients that score want to do the invocation, hit an endpoint, and the endpoint has the SSL termination, it has got the auth, and it has got the traffic split logic there. So users have an endpoint, so the developers deploy an endpoint, and then multiple deployments underneath this. Deployment, you can have more than one. In this example, you can see I've got a blue and a green, and blue is running a different version of the model with running on CPU machines, and green is running on GPU machines. You'll be able to do safe rollout using the endpoint and the deployments in the managed endpoints.
I mean, this is really cool because rolling out software safely is hard, and being able to do it with machine learning is even better. Can you show us how it works?
Absolutely, Seth. So here you can see I have two folders. And first of all, I'll tell you what I'm trying to do here. I'm going to deploy a GPU model into a machine learning model in GPU servers in Azure. So that's what we're trying to do here. And you can see two folders here. One is the GPT-2 model. So in this case, I'm using a GPT-2 machine learning model. It's a popular model for natural language generation. I just cloned it from Hugging Face. It's an open source repo. And then I've got an Azure directory in which I have three files that you need for the deployment. So one is the score.py, which has the logic for loading and scoring the file. Then you have your Python dependencies in the Conda YAML. And then finally, you have the endpoint YAML here. The endpoint YAML just is a configuration for wiring up all your inputs that are needed to deploy, create the model. So you have the endpoint related detail, which is the name and auth and traffic details. And the deployment, you can have, you know, here you have only one deployment named blue. You have model specific details, code details. You're giving all these, wiring up these details for deployment. And finally, you have a GPU machine, the instance type, which queue you want to use for a GPU. So once you set this up, the only prerequisite to create this endpoint is you need to have Azure ML workspace, no other prerequisite. And I'm running the single command, which is AZML endpoint create from my CLI, and just passing this YAML file here. So once you do that, you will get an endpoint which is going to be deployed in Azure in the GPU nodes, and you get a REST endpoint for scoring. So in order to save time, I've run these commands, and I'm going to show you how the experience works in hindsight.
Got it.
So here, I've run this command here. It takes a few minutes. And you can see that, hey, the whole thing is done. The model is registered. I've got an endpoint created. Now let's pull the endpoint details. In order to score it, we need two details, right? We need the scoring URI and the auth details. So I'm using a show command here to pull the scoring URI here. And here I can see the scoring URI, good. And I have a command for pulling the auth, get credentials. And I've actually filled in the details here. It's a REST client similar to a Postman, but built into VS Code, but you can use a REST client of your choice. Here I have put the details of the URI and the token information here. And this is the input. I love pizza because, and I expect the machine learning model to autocomplete. So it's making an invocation right now and it's executing in the GPU nodes. And we have a response here. So it generated some interesting text here.
That's
so this
cool.
This shows you how you are able to deploy a model into GPU and get like an endpoint within like a few steps. So this is all well and good, but I also want to show you the how users can debug this. So people who have tried to deploy models into cloud know how difficult it is to debug their models, because whenever you want to make a change, you want to wait for a few minutes, it goes to the cloud and deploy it. So here what we have is a concept of local deployments. So in this, you are able to create any command that we run, you are able to run that. And all you can do is just do a dash dash local in the end. So in this case, we are doing a AZML endpoint create, and you have to do a dash dash local. I think when I zoomed in, some of the CLI got clipped here. But yeah. I'll show you how it looks. The same command that we did, you just do a flag here. Dash dash local, and you'll be able to execute all of these commands like AZML endpoint invoke and log, get logs. So all of them you will be able to do and like debug locally in a Docker container.
This is amazing. Yeah, this is so hard to do.
Exactly. I want to show you, because the information got flipped, I will show you how this is done. So this is what you do. So when you do this, you create the same YAML that you use for production, but you just do dash dash local. So it's going to deploy in a local Docker image.
That's all really right. Cool.
So this is first part of the demo. Now let's go to the part that you asked, which is safe rollout. How can users do the safe rollout?
Let's hit Control Plus just a couple times to make sure we can see the text.
Yes.
There you go.
So here in this part of the demo, I'm going to show you the safe rollout capability. You have already an endpoint and a deployment which is deployed in production. Let's say we have one deployment named Blue, which is up and running. Now I want to roll out a new model, new version of the model, a more efficient version. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to update the same YAML, and I'm going to add a new deployment called Green here. And here, if you look at my scoring code, I am purposefully putting scoring with error. I'm introducing a parsing error so that I can show you how users will be able to catch this and like roll out a new version.
Right.
And when I want to roll this into production, all I need to do is do a AZML endpoint update and just pass the name of the YAML. You could have updated the same YAML, but for the sake of the demo, I created another one here. And once I do that, let's go to the metrics, Azure Monitor integration, and see what happens. But before that, we had 0% traffic to green, right? So let's divert some percentage of traffic to green. So here I'm going, I'm saying it's 10% traffic to green to start with, and I'm clicking update. So once I update and live traffic, now green is going to take 10% live traffic. Initially it took 0%, now it's taking 10%. And let's go and see the metrics whether our rollout was successful. So here you can see in the metrics page, the first chart shows you that the traffic split between blue and green is good. Like we have 10%, 90%, like 115 requests per minute in blue and 10 requests per minute in green, looks good. But if you look at the status code split that we have here, we are like filtering on green and we are displaying the HTTP status code. You can see in the bottom chart, like all the inputs that came to green are error, which is HTTP status 4XX. So that means something has gone wrong in a deployment. So what we do is we pull our log analytics and we can pin it to green and filter on a specific time. And actually, I can see that there is an error here. You know, I can see in my score.py there was some exception thrown, looks like a parsing error. So I found my issue. So I'm going back and I'm updating the same YAML, but this time I'm going to use a scoring fix. So I fixed that scoring file. It could have been the same score.py that's updated, by the way. and I fire an update command again. So here you will see the power of declarative, how we've like declaratively able to update the YAML. So this is like in aligned with the principles of GitOps, where all the changes go through Git in a declarative way. Everything is audited. So now we fire the update, and let's see if our rollout was successful this time. So this time you have to notice it's an in-place update, right? The first time we did a blue-green, now it's an in-place update. And it's a rolling update that happens in the backend. So we go here. Hey, it looks like our green as all the red has gone down. So basically all the HTTP status code 400 is going down after we pass the fix. And all the HTTP 200 is rising up. This basically means that our script, our fix worked. So all successes after the fix is done. So this is great news. And we can go here back and update the, we can give more traffic here, 50% traffic. And we can see what happens. By the way, we have CLI. You'll be able to do that using the CLI as well. So we are now going to see in the screen 50%, how the 50% traffic looks like. You will see that blue is coming down and green is popping up.
So as that's coming up, I just want people to understand, because I mean, we're going kind of fast. Basically, you're able with the new managed endpoints, you're able to create deployment slots with different models. And what he showed is he showed one that broke everything, but it didn't break us, because only 10% of the traffic went there and he was able to safely update it, which was really cool. Show us what you got right here, my friend.
Yeah, absolutely, sir. So here you can see that now after green is taking 50%, you can see the traffic blue and green are like near 50-50. So this looks good, our traffic update worked. And we can see the latency that blue is taking 95 milliseconds and the new efficient model just taking 23 milliseconds, our P90 latency. So our rollout is successful. Our model is efficient as we expect. So great. And then we can, of course, roll out the 100% traffic, and we are ready to delete blue. So this kind of shows the journey of how user starts from like playing locally with a Docker to make sure all the code and the dependencies work, and then move to the cloud with the first version, monitor SLAs, and then going with the second version with a safe rollout and able to debug any issues and move forward and you know, phase out the old version.
That was cool. And I know we went by really fast, but that journey is super important, because before people would like deploy a Flask app and everything would break. Here you can manage it safely with a deployment with 10%. And then if that breaks, you switch it out and then you move stuff up. This is really cool, my friend. Where can people go to find out more?
So there is a link that's right there displayed. People can go there, and here users would be able to run like a hands-on exercise from starting to end. You know, users would be able to experience this themselves.
Awesome. Well, Sethu, this has been amazing. You've been learning all about managed endpoints here on the AI Show. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully we'll see you next time. Take care.